Hello class, welcome to my third video for the weeks 6 through 7. And today we're gonna be learning the labs and in and out and dribble predict. So enough with the pleasantries, let's just get right on it. The first thing is gonna be dribble protect. So let's talk about dribble protect. All three of these things, of course, we learned last week. Dribble protect, in its sense, what its name is what it's doing. You're trying to protect the ball from the person that's trying to take it from you. If you were to drive up and then someone's right there and you can't get past them, you want to be able to safely retreat without it being stolen. Another name for this is called the retreat dribble. I call it the dribble protect because that's the more common name. So basically you just want to be able to dribble backwards without the person taking it. That's why you have your arm out in front, so that way you can't, so the other person doesn't take it from you. Then sometimes when you're dribbling backwards, you might want to do a crossover and shoot, because dribbling backwards might give you some space if you do it quick enough, and then you might have a time to get a shot off. Okay, now let's talk about in-and-out dribble. The in-and-out dribble is very similar to a crossover in that you're going one direction when actually you're going another. Except that in a crossover you're using one hand and then back to the other hand. When in in-and-out, you're staying with the same hand. Let's say you're using your right hand. You would dribble the ball towards your left hand, but then use that same hand that you're using to push the ball back. So it's simply to one side, then the other side. It's all on the wrist, being able to push the ball one way, grab it before it falls away, and push it back the other direction. And this is kind of a hard concept to describe, so if you have any questions, feel free to email me. And now we'll talk about the final subject for today, layups, the most important shooting aspect in basketball. To do this, there are two steps, getting to the basket and actually shooting. The first step involves three movements. If you're on the right side, stepping with your right foot, then your left foot, then jumping up with your right foot. That way you don't travel, because that's only two steps. If you're on the left side, it's stepping with your left foot, then your right foot, then jumping up with your left foot again. Again, so you only take two steps without dribbling, so you don't travel. The second step in this is shooting just like you would a normal shot, but at an angle so that it bounces off the backboard. You want it to hit the top right corner of the square if you're on the right side, or the top left corner of the square if you're on the left side. If you have any more questions about this, just email me. Okay kids, so in conclusion, we learned the layups, the in-and-out dribble, and the dribble protect. If you have any questions, feel free to email me and I'll see you next week.